All right, guys, so the next part of the descent issues that people might have that are pretty common. The first one that you're gonna see is really, really straightforward and it seems fairly obvious, is actually weight. So I'll go for one of these guys. Is not having the correct weights. There's a few factors that you need to take into account with weight. And obviously it might change from dive to dive as if, you know, a little bit of variance. For the most part, it stays pretty common for most people. You're generally using the same sort of equipment. Generally, a standard setup is normally something like a 5mm wetsuit, a 12-litre cylinder, that sort of thing. So you can roughly calculate what your weight's gonna be. But there is a bit of there can be some variance, especially if you have your own weights, you dive with a thicker or thinner wetsuit, you've got a camera, you've got a few different things, it might change what you should have. When trying to calculate the weight, and this is a fairly common question that I get asked, people will say, how do I know how much weight I've got? I'm 180 centimeters tall and I weigh 80 kilos. So there's no hard and fast rule because people do display a little bit of different buoyancy based on how fit they are, how much body fat they've got, all that sort of thing. But the general rule, if you want to test how much weight you're going to have, is at the surface with a mask, hold your breath, full breath of air. The water level should be sitting at about the midpoint when you have the optimum level of weight. That means you're neutrally buoyant. Okay, so to basically, if you're doing that, full breath of air on the surface, your head's gonna be above the water, that means you're positively buoyant. It means you're gonna have real buoyancy issues when you get below the surface and get to any depth. You'll take a breath in and shoot up, exhale, go down, that sort of thing. So generally speaking, and as I said, this is a generalization, it's not a specific rule, you want about that much based on what you're doing. Okay, so if you've got a 5mm wetsuit and that's what you're used to diving in, you can sort of work out what you need. It's normally around about a fraction less than 10% of your body weight. Okay, again, still a generalization. What I always advise is jump in a pool with no gear on, wetsuit, mask, snorkel, hold your breath, you'll get an idea of what you should be. Second thing to take into account when you're doing that, again, is the type of cylinder, if it's steel or aluminium, because they have a different water displacement. So it does mean that your buoyancy can change, especially with aluminium dives. Generally towards the end, you might find as you go through the air in your cylinder, you're swimming along, your butt's gonna come up a little bit, okay? And that means accounting for that with possibly a fraction more weight. It doesn't have to be a huge amount, all right? So when you're looking at weights, you've got a few different options. Obviously, you've got your standard style dive weights, the sort of 2 and 3 pound options, okay? And then you've got precision weights, which are about 1 kilo or 500 grams. You've got your flat weights here, which can be used. A lot of guys use them for freediving as well. They fit into weight vests, but again, will fit into a BCD. Obviously not gonna be functional for a weight belt. And you've got some people who prefer to get one single large, bigger block. For me, I don't like these so much, purely because it basically goes, you're loading yourself with a whole heap of lead. At least when you've got this lot, or this style of weight, you can go for smaller increments to give yourself that precision weighting. So it means you get just that spot on amount of buoyancy control. So you're sort of slightly less than neutral. That means when you're diving along, you've got all these different weights. You can stow them throughout your BCD, and it gives you that great diving experience. So obviously with those weights, you can see here on the Oceanic BioLite BCD, you've got the dumpable weight pockets here, on the Boucher, you've got them at the front. And a lot of these BCDs now that have these dumpable weight pockets, they also have what are called trim weight pockets on the back. Okay, so these are generally attached to the cam band here. I don't know if you can see here on the side of the bladder of the Boucher, they've got them at the back. They're called trim weight pockets. And what they're designed to do is when you're weighting up and you're getting all your weight together, you pop these in the back. So you put your heavier, so say you've got to use 4 of these or 6 weights of these, say, you put 4 in the back and put 2 in the front to give your weight at the back a little bit more sort of, I guess, gravity. And it's gonna keep your bum down a bit if you're diving in the alley tank. It's also gonna help you stay level in the water when you're swimming along. And especially on this BCD too, being a wing BCD, a little bit more weight in the back means it's gonna be more comfortable when you're on the surface leaning back and swimming back to the boat. But yeah, what I would suggest again, as just mentioned before, if you do have the chance or luxury of doing it, smaller increments of more weight will give you that ability to fine tune how much you actually need to go diving.